Hello students, in this video we are going to study about polarity of carbonyl group. Carbonyl group present in either aldehydes or ketones. Suppose we take a example of aldehyde HCHO or any aldehyde. So in case of aldehyde, this CO group is polar, means due to this oxygen is highly electronegative and which attract a pair of electron towards itself, so which acquire partial negative charge and carbon acquire partial positive charge. Now when this carbonyl compound comes in contact with water molecule H2O, now in case of H2O, this oxygen is partial negative, hydrogen is partial positive. Now in between these molecules there is a formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and when any organic compound form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water, hydrogen bonding with water, then it is water soluble, then it is a soluble in water. So lower members of aldehydes are water soluble, or ketones are also water soluble. Suppose we take an example of acetaldehyde. So acetaldehyde is a water soluble aldehyde because it form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water. So any organic compound when form this intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the water molecule, then it is always a water soluble. Now if we observe in case of if we take the next example of aldehyde, 3 carbon containing aldehyde propanol, if 4 carbon containing aldehyde butyraldehyde is there, and so on. So if we take a 5 carbon containing aldehyde valeraldehyde, then if you observe the hydrocarbon part of these aldehydes, so this is the ethyl part, N-propyl, N-butyl part is nothing but the hydrocarbon part of these aldehydes, and this hydrocarbon part is hydrophobic in nature. Hydrophobic means which repel water, and therefore if the molecular mass increases, so if we go from top to bottom, the molecular mass of this aldehyde increases, solubility decreases, because the hydrocarbon part increases, it's a hydrophobic nature, means water heating. Hydrophobic means which hate water, or water repelling, which repel water. Repelling nature of this hydrocarbon increases, so molecular mass increases, its solubility decreases, because the molecular mass increases, the hydrocarbon part increases, and if the hydrocarbon part increases, the hydrophobic nature of this hydrocarbon part increases, so solubility decreases. This is the most important property of aldehydes and ketones. So lower members of aldehydes and ketones are soluble in water, like acetaldehyde and acetone are water soluble, but acetaldehyde and acetone are water soluble, but the molecular mass increases, means hydrocarbon part increases, the hydrophobic water repelling property increases, and solubility decreases. So this is about the aldehydes and ketones. In case of carboxylic acid, up to C4 carbon containing carboxylic acids, means lower carboxylic acids are soluble in water, but from C4 onwards, they are insoluble in water, means they do not form. Why this C higher carboxylic acid or C4 onwards carboxylic acids are insoluble in water? Because they do not form. So C4 onwards, these carboxylic acids are insoluble in water because they do not form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the water, because they have the hydrocarbon part which is a water repelling group, and therefore these higher carboxylic acids are insoluble in water. But they are soluble in, higher carboxylic acids are soluble in organic solvents like alcohol, benzene, ether, etc. So this is about the solubility of aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acid and their solubility in water. Okay, so this is the most important part about the solubility of aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids. Now next one, the polar nature of aldehyde and ketone which affect on the reactivity of aldehydes and ketones. Suppose we take the example of aldehyde. So in aldehyde, one alkyl group is attached to this carbon and one hydrogen is attached. Now if you observe, this oxygen always carry 4 electrons on it, and when it shows the steric hindrance, means which attract this pair of electron towards itself, now what happened? The single bond is converted into double bond and it is surrounded by 6 electrons and acquire negative charge. This carbon acquire positive charge, hydrogen as it is, this alkyl group as it is. Now this alkyl group shows positive inductive effect, means which repel this pair of electron towards the carbon, and this is the bulky group or the electron repelling group, and due to this electron repelling group, the positive nature of this carbon decreases, and the which undergoes the nucleophilic substitution reaction. So if a nucleophilic addition reactions are takes place in case of these aldehydes as well as ketones. Now there are two factors affect on the reactivity of aldehydes and ketones. First one, influence of electronic effect. So what about the influence of electronic effect? If you observe in case of ketone, so CO group is present in ketone, but this ketonic group or carbonyl group is attached to 2 alkyl groups. So these 2 alkyl groups both shows a positive inductive effect, and to this carbon the nucleophile, means attack of nucleophile means negatively charged ion which attack repelled or is faced by these 2 alkyl groups due to positive inductive effect shown by these 2 alkyl groups, bulky alkyl groups, and it is this repellence is less in case of aldehydes. So in aldehyde only 1 alkyl group is present, in ketone 2 alkyl groups present, and which shows the positive inductive effect. So to the entry of this nucleophile or attack of nucleophile on the carbon, which becomes easy in case of aldehydes, but in case of ketone it is not easy, means the reactivity rate in case of aldehyde is more. Aldehydes undergo easily chemical reactions than the ketones due to presence of two alkyl groups, and which shows the positive inductive effect. The attack of nucleophile on this carbon is not easy, but in case of aldehyde only one alkyl group is present, and the attack of nucleophile on this carbon becomes easy than the ketones. So these aldehydes are highly reactive than the ketones. Now some important commercially available forms of aldehydes and ketones are there. In that first one, formaldehyde is occur in the available commercially form as a solid polymer. This formaldehyde is found in solid polymer, so it is the form of the formaldehyde which is very important commercially, and this solid polymer is called paraformaldehyde. Solid form of formaldehyde is called paraformaldehyde, which is used for the production of polymers. So paraformaldehyde is the solid polymer of formaldehyde, and it is found in two forms. First one, paraformaldehyde is nothing but OH attached to CH2O n times with the H. This is the form of paraformaldehyde, and again it is found in trioxane. So second one, this trioxane means three formaldehyde molecules form a cyclic ring. Suppose we take a one formaldehyde CHO, HCHO, one formaldehyde, second formaldehyde HCHO, third formaldehyde HCHO. So this is the trioxane, means three molecules of formaldehyde form a ring, and this form is called as a trioxane. HCHO, second molecule, this is one more HCHO, and this is third formaldehyde. So they form a ring, and this form is called as a trioxane. So this trioxane and paraformaldehyde are used to prepare dry formaldehyde. When dry formaldehyde is required, dry formaldehyde is prepared from this trioxane and paraformaldehyde. So this is the most important commercially available form of the formaldehyde. Again, this acetaldehyde, second example of aldehyde is acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is also commercially available in solid trimer. So solid form, three molecules of acetaldehyde combine with each other and form a solid trimer called paraldehyde. Aldehyde is the prefix, so trimer of acetaldehyde is called paraldehyde. And tetramer means four molecules of acetaldehyde combine to form a metaldehyde. So this is the most important commercially available forms of acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is found in trimer, its solid trimer called paraldehyde, and its solid tetramer called metaldehyde. So these are few commercially available forms of formaldehyde and acetaldehyde. Now,